everybody. I was posting so many photos with my food, especially Romanian food, that some of you start asking me, what's that, what's that, what's that, what's that? I was trying to explain in English, translating from Romanian, which didn't work very well. But tonight I want to teach you a special dish called BULZ. Yeah, BULZ, B-U-L-Z. The main ingredient is cornmeal. Actually, you can think about the Italian restaurants and think about polenta. If you find polenta powder or something like that, that's very, very good. You can use it, but I use maize, and I'm sure that you'll find the cornmeal in any supermarkets. What I forgot to tell you is don't expect any quantities. I never, especially for this dish, I never expect quantities. I just feel how much I can put from each ingredient. So try to follow step by step. I failed like four times before my BULZ was successful. So be patient and try it.
I will start first with making polenta. So you need the cornmeal. I use 1.5 liters of water for two of us, so that would be more than enough, and if it's anything left you can eat it the next day cold, and it's quite good. So just bring the water to boil and get ready your cornmeal. For a nice taste, I will add some olive oil, a spoon, tablespoon or two. Ignore the glass behind, that my already finished vodka and tonic.
You know, cooking is not a punishment, so when you are cooking, listen to some nice music, have a drink, enjoy that moment. And believe me, if you are not if you don't get very drunk, the food will taste better.
So when the water starts boiling, you start adding small quantities of cornmeal, and be sure that you always mix to don't have any conglomerates of cornmeal in your polenta. And I add enough polenta until the consistency of what I'm mixing now, it's a little bit thicker, not very thick, but just a little bit thicker, and you'll see that in the moment when the water will go back to the temperature of boiling 100 Celsius, the polenta will start to get thicker and thicker and thicker. And don't forget, you need to mix all the time to be sure that you will not have burnt taste or anything wrong with your polenta. By the way, polenta, it's an Italian dish. In Romanian, we call this mamaliga. And another thing, be very careful with your hands. When the mixture starts boiling, it's like a volcano. Look, look, see? Bluk, 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 bluk. And if that bluk, bluk touch your hand, that's very painful. Oops. Sugar. So my polenta is almost ready. You see, that's the consistency that I want. I'm still boiling to be sure that it's cooked. It's not necessary to cook it too much because I'll put it in the oven after anyway, but I like the sound. Listen. Sounds lovely, but you will see when you'll be ready. The taste, it's amazing. Now the next ingredients are the sausages. Ideal is to have Romanian sausages, but if you don't find a shop, you can buy any sausages that they are not a little bit dry, maybe smoked, that will give a better taste. Hungarian sausages are very good. Chorizo, the Spanish sausage is very, very good. But I'm lucky enough to have in Canterbury a Romanian shop from where I buy my sausages. They're frozen, but I will wait to defrost. When the sausages are defrosted, I'll cut them finger size. All right, Miguel is saying they're not finger size. Okay, children finger size. Another very important ingredient for my BULZ is slana. Okay, that's a little bit more complicated. It's actually lard. You can see the layer of the pigskin on top. It's smoked. But if you cannot find slana anywhere, I'm sure that you'll find a Romanian friend who for sure will have some reserves home of slana. That's very good for winter in Romania. You can use some bacon. Choose the fatty bacon and cut it in very, very small pieces. That's such a nice slana. I will have some. And now I will cook the pieces of bacon, slana, letting to melt all the fat, not completely, not until it gets crispy, but at least to get a little bit melted to create enough fat, lard, in the pan to be sure that I can cook the sausages. And when the bacon is half cooked, I will add the sausages, and the smell in the house is absolutely fabulous. Miguel from the other side of the house upstairs is shouting, "I'm hungry!" You are lucky that you can see only the video and hear the sound, and you cannot feel the smell. The smell is absolutely delicious. I will not cook the sausages and the bacon completely because I will put them in the oven later before I will serve my BULZ. As you can see, I removed the bacon and the sausages after they were half cooked, but I kept a little bit of melted lard in the pan because now I decided that I want a different taste in my BULZ, and that's caramelized onion. I use two red onions. So now I'm half cooked them. Once again, don't cook everything 100% because you'll put it in the oven anyway, and when they will be a little bit cooked, I will add a spoon of sugar. The next ingredient that you need is soft cheese or cottage cheese. If you use goat or sheep cheese, the taste will be better. But I didn't find any in the shop, so I'm using normal soft cheese, normal cottage cheese. But I choose the one with the highest percentage of fat, because that will give a better taste to my BULZ. By the time when all the ingredients are ready and I'm almost at the third vodka and tonic, I just check the time. It's 6:30, quite early for dinner. Normally we eat later. And therefore I decided to put everything together and keep it and place it in the oven just half an hour before dinner. By the way, my stomach, it's quite good. I can eat stones, but even with that ability, I need to have my BULZ quite early to avoid a very unpleasant indigestion. For the final stage, you'll need to use something which can face a high temperature in the oven, any type of material. I use a clay pot because the temperature will be equal everywhere in my BULZ and the taste will be better. So you have the clay pot and you get ready to prepare your BULZ. First, you put a layer of polenta on the bottom, and as you can see, my polenta is quite thick, so I'm trying to make it uniform as a layer. Think of lasagna or a moussaka. When the bottom layer is ready on top, try to spread as uniform as you can the bacon with the sausages, the caramelized onion, and the cottage cheese, the soft cheese. If you think that the cheese is not fat enough, I will add on top 10-15 grams of butter cut in small cubes. After that, on top you add the rest of the polenta. When you spread the polenta as even as possible, press it down a little bit, you know, like this. Yeah, just to be sure that the cheese will give a hug to the onion and the lard and the sausages, and that will be a perfect foursome, threesome, whatever, in the middle of your bulz.
Of course, somebody asked me about adding salt to any of the ingredients. Now you can put salt in the water when you're making polenta, or just add some salt with the sausages, the onion, and so on. Now I grew up in a family where we didn't cook with salt. My grandfather, rest in peace, he had heart problems, so we're trying to cut the salt, not the calories, as you can see, but we are trying to cut the salt. But you can add as much salt as you want, but be careful, maybe the sausages are salty already, maybe the bacon is salty, so you need to keep a very good balance.
Now when everything is in my clay pot, what I will do, because we are two for dinner tonight, I will make two little valleys, two depressions to push down in the polenta, like this. One here, oops. It doesn't need to be perfect, but needs to be quite deep. One, it's like a volcano who collapsed. I mean, you see, I learned geology at school, and this is the second one. Now you understand why I make those little depressions in my bulz, because you'll break in each of one an egg. And on top of your eggs, you now put some grated cheese. You can use any cheese you want, but be sure that it's mature and tasty and quite fat. I use mature cheddar, but I think once I used some camembert or Roquefort or whatever cheese I had basically in the fridge. And I spread a little bit on the surface too. Of course, you'll make a mess on the hob, but Miguel will clean it tomorrow. That's team working. So my bulz is almost ready to put it in the oven. As a final touch, because I like the top to be crispy, I will spritz some olive oil. Just a little bit, just to be sure that will be crispy. And whenever I decide that we'll have dinner, half an hour, 40 minutes before, I just pop my bulz in the oven. Now, because my bulz is ready and I want to have dinner in 30-35 minutes, I'll just pop it into the oven. Not very hot oven, I would say around 150-180 degrees, and just keep on on it until the eggs will be cooked. You cannot have bulz without a nice cold sour cream, and once in a lifetime, just leave on the shelf the low fat one. What's the point? Take the full fat one. And as I said, time to time, check how nice the cheese melts, egg is done, and I'll leave it a little bit longer because I like it crispy. So, my bulz is ready. Took me an hour and 20 minutes. Indeed, four vodka and tonics to make it. So, don't be upset if I will not post any video when I'm serving it. But I cannot wait to eat